gentlemen, welcome back to the pinnacle of professional wrestling itself. We are here at Slamforce. We're here with another episode with hard-hitting action, and it is going to be a big night tonight. Guys, we are officially on the road to Slammania. Guys, I am your resident commentator and journalist. I am Joshua Nix, and tonight we have quite a few matches that I am very intrigued to see. And we're going to see the women's champion back here. But before we get back to that, tonight it's going to be the new United States champion, Taz Naji, going one-on-one with Malavai. For the first time ever, Taz Naji arrives here as United States champion. Not only that, Dante Stark and Danny Black go one-on-one for the first time ever here in the Slamforce. It is going to be a big night here.
The following contest is an exhibition match scheduled for one fall. In the ring, please welcome Malavai. And making his way down to the ring, he is the new United States champion, Taz Naji.
They call him the Colossus, the big guy of the sky, and now you can call him the United States champion. It is Taz Naji. But we are going to go back to Retaliation and see how he won that title. Rattling the head off of Mike Watts. Oh my God, he said he's...
I'm sorry, brother.
He said he's sorry. Oh, wait, what is he going to do? Brace for impact. Brace for impact. He could spell the win here that night and claim the U.S. title, and he does. Well, he did it. He climbed his way to the top of one of Slamforce's biggest mountains, and he captured the United States champion from a very determined, and a very dominant and first ever U.S. champion, Mike Watts. Mike Watts held that title for practically a little under a year. It was a long title reign, a long and very, very entertaining title reign. I mean, he had plenty of title defenses. He won it back against Aaron Silvers at the return show of Slamforce back in 2019. It was quite a long title reign. Well, guys, here we are. It is the new champion. Oh, Taz Naji is not playing around. Taz Naji is not playing around. Malavai thought he was going to get a little head games going in, but Taz Naji just sat on him. Full body press. Senton on Malavai. And just look at that. A big, meaty claw right to the side, right to the chest, right to that pec of Malavai. And this is the Taz Naji I think we're going to see come out. We saw come out at Retaliation against Mike Watts. A serious side, a determined side. Someone who wants to win and doesn't just want to be the jokester. He wants to be taken seriously. And I think that's the Taz Naji we're going to get as champion. Remember, this is his first match as champion. This is going to really set his tone going in to the rest of his title reign. And right now, Naji just taking full force of those elbows right into the small of the back of Malavai. Malavai in a little bit of trouble here early going in this match here. Naji just fully taking control and boom, just throws him around. One, two, three, and no, Malavai kicks out at two, and that says a lot. That means a lot of damage is put to Malavai to be at a count of two this early on in a match. Just look at this brute strength and power, and another senton just right on the midsection of Malavai. Malavai, you know he wants a win. He's wrestled in Slamforce before. He's been in the environment of trying to get a win, trying to make a name for himself. And look at that, able to move right out of the way. Thank God here for Malavai, or else he would have been crushed in that corner like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And now Malavai coming right after Taz Naji. And this is what needs to happen. And now look at this, Malavai going for a nice roll up here. Schoolboy one, and only a one count as Naji kicks out. Malavai trying to get any sort of momentum against Naji here. You saw that Insecurity barely took down Najee, and you see Najee saying, come on, bring it. And Malavai is going to continue bringing it. And there is Najee. Just the brute force of the big guy of the sky, the Colossus. Taj Najee. That boot damn near sent Malavai out of the ring. Now Malavai here. In trouble with Taj Najee. And now look at this, Najee. Boom! Humongous power slam by Najee. You can just see Najee feeling himself, knowing he's in control, knowing that he has the opportunity as United States champion to be something Mike Watts was, or even better. Now Malavai trying to roll out of the ring, maybe get a breather, get some space between himself and Taz Najee, and that would be the best bet to do at this moment in time. And you see here, and now look at this, Malavai. Oh, Malavai, there's a quick smartness of Malavai here, and now Malavai on that top rope, and now Malavai, look at this, boom, oh, gets caught by Taz Najee, and the dynamite bomb from Taz Najee. Three, it's over.
Here is your winner, the United States champion, Taz Najee.
What a night for Najee. What a few nights for Najee. He's really definitely come to full form here in Slamforce as the United States champion. Congratulations, because he deserves it. He deserves that, the United States championship. Well, it is not over yet, not by a long shot. Later on tonight, we're going to see a big over-the-top rope battle royal featuring some of the women from our new all-women show, Glory, that will be debuting very soon. Mocha, Kylie, Bibi, Carmelita, Denise, and Nidalee all will be in the ring.
Please welcome to the ring your Slamforce Women's Champion, Reese Lamaster.
Well, Reese LeMaster has definitely come under fire over the last few months from a lot of the women in Slamforce, a lot of people around the world, a lot of people on Twitter, because she's won that title back at last year's Slammania in a match against Zaya, who is no longer with us. And then she hasn't defended that title since. So her reign as champion has really been come into question, especially with these new women being signed. And you have to think, Reese LeMaster wants to address this. Reese LeMaster has addressed it on Twitter, but she's here tonight to address the new women's division of Slamforce, including the new women's show, Glory, that's going to be coming our way very, very shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet for your incomparable Slamforce Women's Champion. Now I'm going to make this very short, because the longer I'm out here, the more I realize how each and every one of you fans makes me just sick. Anyway, now I have an announcement to make. There have been a few additions to my women's division, unfortunately. So with that being said, without further ado, let's introduce these bitches. Up first, Carmelita. Looks like she's full of funk, and she'll tear your heart out. But she's not me. Secondly, Denise Gucci. Old. Very poor. Next, Mocha Bank. Who? Nadali, who I know this one, Stevie Michelle. Hey girl, I am the Alpha, the Omega. And finally, Kylie Rizal. That last one, Kylie LaBelle. I've been doing my research on you, babe. You've been in the wrestling circuit for a decade and you haven't won a single title. Kind of bad if you ask me. But hey, what can you do? Some promotions don't know how to execute their talent correctly. I won't blame you for that. But I will blame you for not trying harder. I will blame you for not wanting to put your foot down and say, okay, I am champion material. Kind of sad if you ask me. Now ladies, with that being said, since I am the leader of the locker room and the standard, don't forget I am your standard. I'm feeling very generous tonight. With our all-new, all-women show, Glory, coming soon, I have spoken with management tonight and I've arranged a match. It will be a 6-women over-the-top rope battle royal. The winner out of the 6 of you will be a future number one contender for my Slamforce Women's Championship. So go get ready, ladies, and don't disappoint your champion. You don't want to do that. I worked way too hard to get all of us here.
Well, Reese the Master really is taking claim that she's the reason there's a women's division here, and because of her hard work that these women now have an opportunity to be seen here. And I'm not going to disagree with that. But not only that, she made the announcement that the winner of the Battle Royal later tonight, the winner is going to get an opportunity at Wrestle Master in the future and the Women's Championship. What a big announcement. But guys, up next, we're heading down to ringside as Dante Stark and Danny Black go at it.
The following exhibition match is scheduled for 1-4. Introducing first, this is Dante Stark.
Well, here he is. It is Dante Stark making his way down to the Slamforce ring another time here. He's wrestled here before, and he wants to make sure that he can make a name for himself. I mean, Dante Stark, I'm going to be honest with him. Right now, if you're rewatching your footage of your match like you should be to get even better than you are, you need to be determined. You need to take your foot and put it one foot in front of the other. Right now, Dante Stark, I feel he's very stagnant. This is coming from a place of criticism, but to make you better, get determined. Get where you need to be and feel where you need to be, because right now you need to be in the mindset of wanting to be a champion here in Slamforce. And he's gonna have a very hard task ahead of him against Danny Black. And there he is. He is Danny Black.
Introducing his opponent, making his way down to the ring, this is Danny Black!
Well, Danny, he made his debut back at Retaliation against Aaron Silvers in what was a great match between himself and Silvers. Of course, Silvers would come out the victor, and Silvers has been baiting on Twitter for the last few months that he should be number one contender for the Slamforce Championship because he's undefeated since last year's Slammania, proving that he is the challenger for Joshua Benjamin, the champion to beat. And that's a match I would love to see one-on-one. We saw them go one-on-one in a gauntlet match though at last year's Slammania, but sometime soon I want to see Silvers and Benjamin go one-on-one. Silvers thinks he's the GOAT, the real champion. Joshua Benjamin is still proving from day in and day out that he is the champion. But guys, on to other news. It is Danny Black. This man is very mysterious, very quiet, keeps to himself. But this man, when he's in a ring, he goes. And when he goes, he goes. Here we go. It's going to be one-on-one action here. Danny Black, Dante Stark, one-on-one for the first time ever here in Slamforce. It's both men trying to feel each other out here, but Danny Black gets full control of Dante Stark right away as the Irish whips him to the ropes, drops down again, trying to trip up. But no, and now look at this. Ooh, kicks him right in the face. I feel like that is what happened to Danny Black at Retaliation. Danny Black looking to play a little mind games. It didn't get into the head of Silvers, and it didn't get into the head of Dante Stark here, as Dante Stark attacks the arm of Silvers. Now just drives the elbow right into the thigh here, and now just full-fledged punches right to the knee, trying to weaken the strength of Danny from his knees. Only a one count there as Danny kicks out at one. Right now, Dante Stark in full control of Danny, and it's something that I wouldn't have expected starting off this match. Then again, we're only a few moments into this match, but Dante Stark, he's looking like he's determined to win here. Stomping the chest of Danny right into the mat here, practically through his back. And only a two count there for Dante Stark. Dante Stark really trying to handle Danny here. Throws him into the corner and a kick right to the, and a punch. Oh, and Danny just with a boot, able to get a boot up here. And now Danny with the elbow right to the side of the face. And you see Danny looks pissed off. And Danny just a nice backbreaker. Damn near neckbreaker, actually. I mean, that neck landed right on the knee there. And now look at this, Dante Stark in a fight back against Danny here. And now Danny and Dante Stark teaming off in a strike back battle, but now here's Danny Black just with nasty strikes, that one laying out Dante Stark, a big forearm right underneath the jaw, will definitely lay out an opponent, especially with someone the size of Danny Black. Danny Black definitely needs a win here tonight to secure himself really a spot here in Slamforce. I mean, you can't lose and lose and lose and lose and then expect to still be here. We want winners. Danny Black, be a winner. And I'm not saying that at all with disrespect, Danny. I don't want you to come after me. I am just a commentator. I am Joshua Nick. I'm just saying this from a commentator standpoint, telling you what you need to do. And there was only a two count there for Danny Black. Danny Black here throws him into the corner. Ooh, and a nasty chop right to the chest, and another chop lighting up the chest of Dante Stark here. Now look at this, Danny, nasty overhand chop to Dante, and that damn near took the breath out of Dante Stark. Now Dante Stark here. Ooh, gets his eyes raped. And Dante, nasty suplex there. There's a nasty throwaway exploder suplex landed Dante on the back of his neck. Did you see the landing? It was nasty, vicious, everything that Danny Black is. Danny Black needs to channel it and keep that nasty, vicious side up above water here. Now look at this. Danny just wailing away at the chest of Dante Stark. Oh, and a punch right to the ear. That is going to send anyone's ear ringing. Nasty full force punch. The velocity from that punch was nasty. And now just look at this, just driving the air, every bit of consciousness out of Dante Stark. And only a two count. Dante very barely able to kick out of that there. Just powered out just at the right moment before that ref hit three and Danny would have gotten the win. Danny now up to that top rope here. Could Danny be looking for Dante able to get up out of nowhere? Now look at this. Dante runs up on the ropes and boom! Dante Stark on fire here tonight. Both of these men need a win and only one of them will walk out with the W. And a big knee right underneath the jaw of Danny Black. He's right near the ropes there, two, and no, Danny Black kicks out. Danny Black showing his strength, able to kick out there, gain awareness, and just kick out. And right now, you see Dante Stark here pulling everything out. Now gonna tie Danny Black up in the ropes here and just wrench down. Nasty, nasty spider hole. And now look at this. Oh, a kick right to the face. He hit the right in the bridge of the nose of Danny Black. Dante Stark here, waiting for Danny Black here. And a knee, once again, this time right in the middle of the face, trying to break the damn nose of Danny Black. The ref at a count of three here, throws Danny back into the ring here. Dante Stark going up to that top rope, doing everything he can to put the pressure on Danny in a nasty clothesline. And Danny Black now trying to get any sort of air. And now look at Dante Stark just pulling everything out. Just keeping the pressure on Danny Black. This is the type of Dante Stark I want to see. Dante Stark putting the pressure on Danny Black, but now it's Danny Black. Danny just sent Dante right into those steel steps. And you can see Danny Black here not taking anything very well. And a nasty forearm. The ref here at a count of five and now at a count of six. Danny has to pay attention to this ref's count. The ref is at a count of seven, a nasty forearm. Oh God, and now look at this. Dante Stark, throws him over the barricade here, but Dante needs to get in the ring. Oh my God, he got in the ring.
Here is your order. Oh, this is not going to sit well with
Danny Black. This is a win by countout. Either way, it's a win for Dante Stark. But this is a win by countout. A win's a win. But by countout, this is not going to sit well with Danny Black. Danny Black looks pissed. Oh my God, I would not want to be on the wrong side of Danny Black. Not at all. Dante Stark with a big win. His first one, I believe, here in Slamforce. Oh, wait. Danny Black attacking Dante Stark, and I knew this is not going to sit well with Danny. Dante Stark being attacked with headbutts. And now look at this. The ref's calling for the bell, but I don't think anything's going to stop this attack on Dante Stark. A win is a win. God, and now look at this. Oh my God, no, we need to get help out here. We need to get help out here. Danny Black just attacking Dante Stark here. What else is he gonna do? Dante Stark trying to get any sort of composure. Oh no, oh my god, oh my god, and now just look at this. Choking with a mandible claw down the throat of Dante Stark, and I think Dante is spitting up freaking blood. Dante is spitting up blood. He's spitting up blood. We need, ref, get him off of him. This is ridiculous. Dante is not going to be able to freaking wrestle ever again in his life. Ref, oh wait. Oh my god, that's Najee, Taz Najee. Oh wait, yeah, he spit out blood. Something is seriously wrong with Dante Stark, but here comes Taz Najee to stop the attack and the madness. Oh god, and look at this. Najee said it's not gonna go down like this. Oh wait, the lights just went out. The lights just went out. Wait, can we get those lights back on? What the hell just happened? Wait, where did Danny Black go? But Taz Najee checking on Dante Stark.
And that is how I lost my virginity at church.
Oh, Carmelita, you little nasty freako.
Oh, whatever. You totally still love me. Well, we should go get ready for our match. We're totally gonna kill it. Good luck, Kylie. I'll see you out there. In the meantime, I'm gonna go have some fun with Brad in the security office. He was totally checking me out earlier, and I think I have a good shot. I think he wants to fill me up. See you later.
All right now, I'll catch you later. Wear a condom, baby.
No, what are those things? No, thank you. Bye, Kylie.
Bye.
Well, 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 look who it is, Miss Veteran. Almost 10 years in the game and you're still straddling the fence, just trying to make it big. I remember meeting you back in Exodus. Not much has changed, but as you can see, I'm a champion. Yes, a champ. And you're just still some little dusty hoe who thinks she can wrestle, in all honesty. I hope you win today. I would just love to send you back into obscurity where you belong. You may be a veteran, but this is my locker room. And I expect you to be on your best behavior, keep your guard up, and expect the unexpected.
Rice and beans, la masturbate. You looking as sloppy as ever. And let's not get into accolades and experience. In Exodus, you were a live event champion, baby. Like... a live event champion, you clown ass bitch. And here in Slamforce, you're even cornier than you already were. The only reason you had that Slamforce Women's Championship is because a bitch like me wasn't here while you was fighting weak subpar ass bitches who think they can wrestle like Gigi Sky. Come correct or don't come at all for the queen. I'll keep this short and sweet for you, Reese. I am not one to be trifled with. You can butter me up all you want out there in front of them fans and say that I ain't been booked properly and yada 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 and I have been here for 10 years in this industry without a championship. All you want, but I see right through all that bullshit. Expect me to come for that title. Take notes while you at ringside watching me do my thing tonight. And get this, here is the most important thing you should do. Keep my fucking name out your mouth. Toodaloo.
Oh my god. You want to talk about a reckless mouth? Kylie got a reckless mouth. Guys, Reese LeMaster, you know she's not going to take any of this lying down. Reese LeMaster is a women's champion, the women's champion, and she's going to be at ringside watching this big battle royal go down to see who will be the number one contender for her women's title. But guys, right now we're changing gears. We're going to none other than Explicit.
I'm a game changer.
please welcome to the ring, this is Explicit.
Well, guys, this is Explicit, the first ever Slamforce champion, and he had the opportunity to regain it for a second time back at Slamforce Retaliation, where he went one-on-one in what was a very hard-hitting, intriguing match against Joshua Benjamin. You want to talk about proving yourself. Joshua Benjamin did that at Retaliation when he went one-on-one with the first ever Slamforce champion, defended the Slamforce title against Explicit, and beat Explicit in a unimaginable fashion. A one in a million from the stage onto the concrete. It was a great match, and you guys definitely want to go check that out at some point. Explicit versus Joshua Benjamin at Retaliation. But Explicit has been in a very foul mood as of late, ever since that loss, and it's understandable. Who wants to lose? I wouldn't. But not only that, who would want to lose a championship opportunity like Explicit had? I wouldn't.
Now, before I whip some ass out here, I just want to address someone. JB, you may have beat me 1, 2, 3, and I respect that, but Benjamin, you are no face, you are no draw, and certainly you are no champion. You're standing in a light that's dimming real quick, because I am not the only one out for your humiliation and your demise. Just because you beat me, don't think I'm going away. You have so many people on your back looking to take the spot and fill the shoes that I left empty. Retaliation was just a warning shot. I'm still coming for you, bitch. Are you in attendance? Are you watching at home? Listen closely. Slamforce isn't the business. I'm the damn business.
Well, damn. Explicit putting everyone on notice, and especially Benjamin. Wait. What's going on here? The fans are getting crazy right now. A little bit rowdy. I'm a little bit afraid for my life right now. What's going on right now? The fans are getting rowdy as hell right now. Is someone in the audience? Wait, who the hell's that? Wait, that's Ziggy Star. Ziggy Star, we haven't seen Ziggy Star here in months. What is Ziggy Star doing here, guys? Ziggy Star is a former Slamforce wrestler, and Explicit does not look too happy. Explicit is supposed to have a match up here next. What is Ziggy Star doing here? We'll find out. We'll find out right after this break. Well, we are back here. Yes, Slammania is right around the corner. But guys, impromptu match, huge announcement. Explicit isn't going to go against his original opponent. Apparently, he's going against Ziggy Star right now as per Slamforce management. I didn't even know Ziggy Star was signed back to a damn contract. The hell? But hey, I'm here for it. Ziggy Star versus Explicit right now. And look at this. Explicit just pushing Ziggy down. You know, Explicit is in a foul mood, like I said, and that now he has to go against someone the likes of Ziggy Star. And you know, Explicit thinks everyone's below him, but especially Ziggy Star. Ooh, went for a big boot, but Ziggy Star able to move out of the way very quickly. And now Ziggy Star here, coming after Explicit, just with shots right on the back. Now, ooh, shot right to the Achilles tendon area. That could damn near cause an injury. And now you have Ziggy Star going up to that top rope and a big moonsault. Perfectly executed moonsault on Explicit, going for a three count for the win. Three, and now Explicit able to kick out. Gotta think Explicit was not expecting some of the likes of Ziggy Star to pop up here tonight. And then to also change his opponent to face Ziggy Star. Slamforce management did. I didn't even know Ziggy Star was a part of Slamforce. I didn't know he signed a new contract. Nobody knew. Ziggy Star coming back here, and tonight he could get a big win against a former Slamforce champion in Explicit. Where does that put Ziggy Star? My question though is, where has Ziggy Star been? We have not seen Ziggy Star in months, years actually, here in Slamforce. Where the hell has he been? Now Explicit here just raining away, which stomps right into the corner. This is who Explicit is. Explicit loves to just, oh, just look at that. That's the dirtiness of Explicit. Taking the hair of Ziggy Star and driving it now right back into the mat. That is the dirtiness. And now just wailing and pounding away as Ziggy Star tries to cover up. Ziggy Star definitely looks like he's lost a little bit of weight. He definitely looks a little bit lighter than the last time I saw him. But Ziggy Star trying to fight back here against Explicit. But look at Explicit. Explicit just whipping Ziggy Star around by his own hair. The afro. Now look at this. This is who Explicit is. He likes to take his opponents, beat them down, talk trash to them, and make sure they don't get up. Well, it didn't happen at Retaliation to Joshua Benjamin. Because if it did, Explicit would be standing here as world champion, and he's not. But for the disrespect of Ziggy Star to come out of nowhere, I guess he was sitting in the crowd earlier tonight. We just didn't see him. He was out of our minds. But the fans saw him, and now they went crazy. And now Explicit versus Ziggy Star for the first time here. Actually, no, not the first time. These two have faced off before in Ziggy Star's debut match here in Slamforce back in 2018, I want to say. Now look at this, Ziggy Star getting a little bit of momentum here. Very unique offense from Ziggy Star, that spinning head scissors. Ziggy Star here, Irish whipping the former Slamforce champion. Nice leapfrog there from Ziggy. And now Ziggy, 2 feet right up in the air. Boom! He's gonna stun Explicit here, and now the lightweight Ziggy going up to that top rope. What could he be looking for? Ziggy Star. Oh, went for a nice, ooh, caught him. Caught him here into a big power bomb. Shades of Taz Najee with that spirit bomb. Dynamite bomb. Ooh! Only a two count there. Didn't quite put it away like Taz Najee put away Malavai earlier tonight with that big power bomb. Now look at this, Explicit here. Ooh, ref! That was a low kick. That was a low, low kick. Ref better go check that and run the tapes back. That was a low kick. Explicit now. Just look at this, just beating down Ziggy Star. I don't think Ziggy Star was even ready to compete here tonight. He just took off his shoes. He just took off his shoes. Now Explicit here, stalking Ziggy Star. Oh, and goes right after the leg of Ziggy Star. This is Explicit. He wants to be back in that title picture. He put a warning out for Joshua Benjamin that he's not done with him and called him the B word. Now he's once again attacking the leg of Ziggy Star. Just methodically trying to take away the leg so Ziggy Star can't move. He can't fly. He can't leave his feet. And now, oh, a nice knee breaker. Right on the knee. That's going to definitely jam up the knee of Ziggy Star. Now just look at this. Oh, a leg drop on the knee. Explicit doing everything he can here tonight to just make sure Ziggy Star does not walk out the victor. And I mean, I would say if Ziggy Star walks out the victor here tonight, Explicit should feel humiliated. Now just look at this going right after that knee, and now just look at this. A nice knee bar. A nice knee lock, a standing knee lock from Explicit. And you can see Ziggy Star trying to straighten out the leg so he doesn't have any damage. But the knee bar is locked in here, and Ziggy Star needs to find a way to get out or tap out. Because that knee has been through a lot of damage in the last few moments. And now look at that, using that other leg to get out of it. And now look at this, Ziggy Star gets caught by Explicit. Boom. Going for the pinfall, stacks him up after that spine buster, and only a two count as Star kicks out. Ziggy Star kicks out here, is still alive in the fight against Explicit. And you see that knee is really bothering Ziggy Star here, is really attacked here. But now Ziggy Star getting some feeling back in that knee, and now just a big German suplex. And now look at that, trying to get feeling back in that right knee, and now here comes Ziggy Star full steam ahead. Oh, a nice shoulder block by Ziggy Star here. Now look at this, what is Ziggy thinking of doing? Oh, elbow right to the side of the face of Explicit, and a big stunner, a stunner, a stunner by Ziggy Star. This could spell the end for Explicit. And only a two count for Ziggy, as Ziggy is upset over not getting the win there. And you can visibly see it. His leg has been attacked. He's been through so much damage in this match. And Ziggy Star wants to try and end this as quick as possible. Imagine getting a win here tonight. Ziggy Star on his first night back under contract, I would guess, with Slamforce. Oh! And now Explicit just raining in punches. But Ziggy Star here trying to follow up here and try and get any sort of momentum back in his area of the ring here, in his swing. And a big neck breaker by Ziggy Star. As now Ziggy Star fired up here. Ziggy coming in full steam ahead, and a big suicide dive from Ziggy Star on the Explicit Poison. What a match between these two men. Now look at this. Explicit in trouble here. Ziggy Star in a big crossbody on Explicit. Ziggy Star is on fire here tonight on Slamforce. Ziggy Star stalking Explicit here. And now look at this, rolls through, but a nasty punch right in between the eyes of Ziggy Star, cutting off all momentum he possibly could have gotten. And then break of the eyes, come on ref, right in front of you. And now just look at this, the dirtiness. This is what I'm telling you, Ziggy, watch out for Explicit. He is a dirty man. He will do anything and everything to get a win, especially after the embarrassment and the loss at Retaliation. But he got the knees up after Explicit was going for that frog splash. And there is another one of those big, nasty stunners by Ziggy. Ziggy going up. Oh, God. Could he be looking for that signature elbow drop? Nasty elbow drop. A flying star from the skies. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No! Explicit just suffered another loss, and nonetheless to Ziggy Star. This is not going to sit well with Explicit. Guys, Ziggy Star just got a win over Explicit. I didn't even know he was under contract. But guys, Ziggy Star's back, I guess. How do you guys feel about that? Went over Explicit. Explicit, this ain't gonna go down well.
I'm back. Did you miss me, Slamforce? I'm sure you did. The last time all of you seen me, well, things didn't go as well as I thought it would. At Slam Mania last year, I made a mistake. A big one. I failed my brothers. I took some time off, recollected my thoughts, regathered my footsteps, but not one single phone call or message, email, or anything from them. They abandoned me. But I understand why. I understand that it should have been me all along. I should have been in the world title picture, not Dominic King. That's the past. This is the present. I am the future. Like they say, if you don't risk, there's no reward, so I'm putting it all on the line. I'm declaring for the full gamble ladder match at Slam Mania, and I will do everything it takes and show everyone that I belong here, and I will claim my spot at the top of this business. Slamforce, see you soon.
Well, Jalen Cash is back And we saw a lot of faces come back here tonight, and apparently Jalen Cash is back, and he's declaring himself for the full Gamble ladder match at Slammania. Guys, what that is that there's going to be a contract hung around above the ring. The winner who obtains it will get a future opportunity at any time, any choosing, at any champion they want. Jalen Cash officially announced his declarance for the full Gamble ladder match. But up next, guys, it is going to be the biggest cover reveal of all time. Gigi Sky returns back. She's back.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to Slamforce, Gigi Sky.
She's back. It is Gigi Sky. We have not seen her in Slamforce for quite some time. Apparently, she's been making moves outside of Slamforce. She got herself the Vogue cover. I mean, congratulations. And we're going to be able to see it tonight. So excited. So excited. But guys, the last time we saw Gigi Sky, she was getting pounced on by Tazna G at Slammania last year. It's practically been a year since we've seen Gigi Sky. And now she's back. She's looking amazing. She told us that she lost 15 pounds. She looks proud. But I'm ready for this cover review. Oh, come on. No, no, no. We don't need a mic. We don't need a mic. We don't want you to talk. Just show us the cover.
I know. You guys have been waiting for so long for me to return back here to Slamforce. It feels great to bless y'all. It really does. I've been up to so much since I was sidelined because of Tazna G. But with every big cloud comes a silver lining. And mine came in the form of Vogue. Tonight, I'm gonna quench every single man's thirst. But first, let me just say, tonight, I got a close-up look at the trash management brought in. Foul-mouthed freakos, screwing security guards, frog-eyed bitches, yes, you, Kylie, but real talk. I thought we scraped the bottom of the dumpster with Reese, and management has now picked the roaches from underneath the dumpster to wrestle here. But they won't matter, because Reese, me and you, baby girl, we have unfinished business. And what I want is what was supposed to be mine, the Women's Championship. I mean, it makes sense. I'm on magazine covers, major news outlets, and tonight I present Gigi on Vogue. On my next magazine cover, it's gonna say Gigi Sky, the Slamforce Women's Champion. But let's stick to right now, the present. Let me quench your thirst. Who's ready to see my June 2021 Vogue cover?
Well, yeah, I'm ready to see it. I know I'm ready to see it. I know these fans are booing in this arena right now, and it's really disrespectful to Gigi Sky. But I know everyone around the world is ready to see this Vogue cover reveal. It is a big accomplishment to be on the cover of Vogue, and Gigi Sky has done it. Even after getting pounced by Tazna G, she is now at the prime of her career. And look at it, she is now on the cover of the June 2021 Vogue edition. It is going to be great. Congratulations to this big monumental accomplishment for Gigi Sky. But guys, we are changing gears.
The following contest is a six-woman over-the-top rope battle royal. The only way to be eliminated is to be thrown over the top rope and have both feet hit the floor. The last woman standing will not only be the winner, but will also become the number one contender for the Slamforce Women's Championship. Introducing the first participant, this is Mocha.
A lot of implications on the women's championship picture, because the winner of this battle royal, this over-the-top rope battle royal, will not only win tonight's first ever historic women's main event match, but will also go on to challenge Risa Master for the women's champion. Well, this is Mocha, guys. Mocha stands at 6'1", and she is actually the first ever transgender woman to step foot in the wrestling ring. It's a groundbreaking, barrier-breaking, glass ceiling-breaking moment for this woman here tonight on Slamforce. So congratulations, but you know what would be even bigger? If she's able to survive and outlast five other women to win this battle royal.
Introducing the second entrant, this is Carmelita.
Well, this is Carmelita. Carmelita, a little spicy blonde spitfire she is. We saw her earlier on tonight, and I really hope she used protection if she got what she got earlier on tonight from the security office. But Carmelita is here. She stands at 5'8", and I know she's ready to get down and dirty and fight and make sure she gets a win here tonight. I mean, a win is something all these women want.
Introducing the third entrant, Mrs. Baby.
One of the women I think has a big opportunity in this match is Vivi. I mean, she has a look, she has everything about her. She is the total package. Vivi stands at 5'2". She is quite tiny, but at the same time, she's explosive. And from the look to her in-ring ability, this woman definitely has an opportunity here tonight to make and stake a claim for the Women's Championship of Slamforce. And in my opinion, this is my top pick to win here tonight. I mean, she has the vixen look, and maybe she has the vixen ways of winning.
Introducing the fourth entrant, this is Denise.
It is none other than Denise. Denise, she has the experience. She is the mother of Slamforce, as she's claiming from here on out. She is the oldest living active women's wrestler in wrestling today. I mean, this woman is a grandmother and still doing the do, dropping it low and kicking butts wherever she goes. This is Denise, and I'm very excited to see her in Slamforce. I mean, this woman, a whole lot of women, is going to be a whole lot of problem to deal with. You know, she does have quite the friendship with Kylie, and we're going to see how that plays out in this battle world where it's every woman for themselves. I mean, every woman for themselves, but we're also going to see a lot of maybe odd pairings here. Oh, and here comes another competitor. It is Needley.
Introducing the fifth participant, this is Needley
is one of the strongest competitors I would say in this match. Given her stature, she can bench press four whole men probably, I would say. This woman is super strong. She has a background in powerlifting. You have to know that strength factor is going to come into play here tonight in this battle royal, where you have to lift your opponent up, have enough strength and power to lift your opponent up, throw them over the top rope to eliminate them, and outlast five other women in doing this. So I have to say, Needley definitely has a good percentage of chances of winning here tonight with that powerhouse strength training background that she has.
Introducing the sixth and final participant in this battle royal, it is Kylie.
Kylie is 4'11", and she is a slice of heaven. Kylie, we saw her earlier tonight. Her and Reese got into a little spat backstage. They have a little bit of a history, and now Kylie is here tonight, and she wants to win this battle royal, as does every other woman. But she definitely wants to win this battle royal to try and take that women's championship from Reese LeMaster. Let's talk about Kylie and Denise, though. They've been friends and known each other for over 10 years. Kylie met Denise when Kylie was only 15 and getting started out in the wrestling business. Kylie has a lot of history with a lot of these women. Kylie and BB hate each other. Capital H-A-T-E, hate each other. So this battle royal is going to be very interesting with all these dynamics. And here we go, all the girls look phenomenal. They are ready to fight in this battle royal. But now the question is, who is going to win the battle royal? There's Mocha, Carmelita, Kylie, Nidali, Denise, and BB. Here we go, six woman battle royal for the first time here in Slamforce. This is a match that is main eventing woman and a battle royal. You see Kylie and Mocha going at it there. You see Carmelita and BB, Denise and Nidali. Now look at this, there up at the top of the stage is none other than the women's champion, Reese LeMaster. All these women. Oh, nasty, just headbutt right into the corner from Nidali on Denise. And you see Nidali going right after Denise here. Throws her outside the ring. Remember, this is over the top rope. Denise is not eliminated just yet. And now just look at this. Nidali coming right after Carmelita. Nidali going right after Carmelita there. And you see BB following along here. And now Carmelita getting tag teamed on here by BB. But in the other corner, you see Mocha and Kylie going at it. Kylie definitely the smallest woman in this match here. Now Kylie going right after Mocha. Mocha quite a bit bigger than Kylie here. And now you see none other than BB and Nidali going after Carmelita here. And Carmelita, boom! Nasty big back body drop. And now, be careful. She's going over the top rope. She needs to watch out here. She really needs to watch out. Oh, and she's able to catch herself on that rope, but oh my god, that was very, very, very scary for Kylie to be in that position and predicament here in a battle royal. Why would you put yourself in that predicament? But she did, but she saved herself, and she's going right after Mocha here. And now, Nidali and BB going continuously after Carmelita here. Oh, just look at this. Just teaming on Carmelita. Denise still in the fray here. She needs to get back in the ring though. And Denise, here comes Denise back in the ring here. And now look at this, Denise going right after Nidali. Oh, ooh, and BB. Look at this, BB coming into, oh, and now Kylie coming in after BB. Uh-oh. Look at this, Kylie going after Carmelita, running around the ringside here. And now Nidali and BB in big trouble here from Kylie and Denise. And now just look at this, going right after. Oh, okay, shake the boot, okay. Big stink faces in the corner, the three of the women, BB, Nidali, and Mocha. The fray definitely, it's like the house has split here. And now Carmelita with a nice handstand into a kick. Carmelita going right after. Now just stepping up, choking her with the boot here to Mocha. And then Nidali, Kylie going right after BB. Nidali in that far corner, but now look at this, goes right after BB, almost eliminating BB, but through that second rope, so BB is still in the fray as Nidali and Denise all these women really trying to throw each other over the top rope, but it's not connecting. It's very hard to throw anyone over the top rope. And especially for Kylie. I mean, Kylie is the smallest woman in this match here. And now Carmelita going after. What are these women doing here? What are they thinking? Oh, shimmying to each other. And now look at this tag team action. Oh, what a perfectly executed tag team action. We saw Carmelita and Kylie earlier on in tonight. I mean, I wonder if Carmelita got with the security guard. Oh, and just throwing Mocha by the hair is Kylie, as Nadali trying to get any sort of air here. Now look at this. Mocha went for a big power bomb, but look at that. Kylie was able to reverse it into a Hurricane Rana here. What an amazing battle royal thus far. No one has been eliminated yet though. And now Denise just runs over Carmelita. Now Denise fully in control of Carmelita. Ooh, just a shot across the chest. And now Mocha. Ooh, kick right under the chest area of Kylie. And now just look at this, just the long legs of Mocha coming into play, hanging Kylie up there, choking her. Denise. Could Denise be looking for here? And now look at this. Oh, Denise runs through BB. Denise just runs through BB. Ooh. Right in the corner here. And you see Mocha still going after none other than Kylie. Trying to maybe try and eliminate Kylie here. Oh, wait. Look at the strength of Mocha. And now look at this. Ooh. Just swings her across with a big backbreaker. The unbridled strength of Mocha will definitely be a playing factor here tonight in this battle royal. Now, if she can only eliminate Kylie, this would be her moment to do so. Kylie looks in a downward state here. Denise here. Denise, what is she looking? Oh, Denise! Hip bump to Carmelita, and now a hip bump to BB. And now Denise showing that maybe she wants the title. Denise, so much charisma does Denise have. And now you see Carmelita, trying to gain any sort of momentum here. And now look at this, Denise planting Mocha with a big spine buster. The two of the biggest women in this match now going at it. Now look at this, Denise, unbridled power, throwing, tossing Mocha across the ring. And now look at this, Denise here. Denise going for something here. And now look at this, Denise. Oh my God! Denise just threw Mocha over the top rope. That is an elimination. Mocha has been eliminated. And now look at this. That was unbridled strength. I just can't even believe what I just saw. And a nasty face buster. Remember, you have to go over the top rope. Denise nor BB have been eliminated, but Mocha has. And now look at this, Nadali going after Carmelita. Ooh, just took the backs of her fist and whacked her with like a baseball bat to the face of Carmelita. Carmelita looks to be in trouble here. And now Nadali. Look at the strength of Nadali here. Nadali just a nasty sit out face buster. Her arms are trapped behind her, landing her head first. Kylie may be knocked the hell out. Now look at this. I wonder who Reasonable Master wants to face. Who does Oh, there goes Carmelita. Carmelita gets eliminated. Just kicks to the face. Denise now trying to get any wherewithal here. Gets back in the ring here. Now look at this. BB and Nadali going after Denise. This is a dream team here, and it's been working thus far, but not for long. Denise takes both their heads and bashes it. And now look at this. Oh, nastiness by BB. rakes her in the eyes. That is going to really affect her for the rest of the match. If you can't see, you can't eliminate your opponent. Now look at this. Here comes... Oh! Hangs her up. And now wait. Oh, Carmelita tried to go after BB, but watch out behind you. BB screaming. BB is screaming. Oh God. Oh, she just snatched the wig. She just snatched the wig. Oh my God. Oh my God. She just snatched the wig of BB. And Carmelita's laughing. And the slap right across the face of Carmelita, and BB is hightailing it out of here. Carmelita right after her. Oh my God. What a battle royal. Oh my God. Denise snatched BB's wig, and now Kylie. And Denise going after Nidalee. Oh my God. Want to talk about tag teaming? How about this? Nidalee in big trouble here. I can't believe Denise snatched BB's wig off. Oh my God. That's a first I haven't seen. Oh God, and now look at this. Both women here. Big suplex. A double suplex from Kylie and Denise as they work together as a team here. But remember, it may be teamwork right now. But what you need is a win. Oh, perfectly executed double split leg drops to Nidalee. Teammates may become your worst enemies here. But it could help you too, as now look at this, full steam ahead, but no. Nidalee able to get out of the way here. Nidalee fighting back against Denise. Now Denise in trouble here with Nidalee. And now Nidalee turns back to Kylie. Runs right through Kylie. We saw three eliminations thus far. Mocha, BB, and Carmelita. Denise in their corner trying to regain composure at any point she can here. And now just look at this. Slamming the face of Kylie is Nidalee. Kylie LeVou is right now in a lot of trouble here with Nidalee. The bigger, stronger Nidalee, and a nasty chokeslam to Kylie. That is a back-shattering chokeslam. You see, Kylie looks out of it here. Denise is down in the corner as well. And Nidalee is in full control of these women. My first pick was BB. But right now, my second pick right now is Nidalee. As she's, oh my God, she lifts up. She lifts up Denise here, and now she throws Denise over the top rope. Oh, wow. Yep, my pick to win this is Nidalee. Straight up Nidalee. Look at this power Nidalee just showed. Tossing the bigger Denise out, and you can see how disappointed Denise is. She wanted to win this battle royal. She wanted to face Riesla Master for the women's title, and Kylie able to get a boot up here. The action continues in the ring, and now Kylie, oh, runs through, and now just look at this, boom, shots away. There's one after another, shots, and now you can see Kylie doing anything she can. Ooh, a nice atomic drop, two atomic drops, and this time tripping up Nidalee. Kylie in full control of Nidalee here. Could Kylie maybe get into a victory here tonight and be a number one contender for Riesla Masters Women's Championship? Now look at this. Ooh, just chops her right in between the head here. Nidalee in full control. What a battle royal. We saw four eliminations thus far. And right now we could see number five here as Nidalee just overpowering Kylie. I don't know how Kylie is going to get out of this predicament with the bigger, stronger Nidalee. Just a gut buster by Nidalee. My bet is on Nidalee. I think Nadalia is going to challenge Risa Master for the women's title. Now look at this. Kylie trying to fight back in any way she can here. And now Kylie here trips up Nadalia. And look at this, a nasty kick right to the side of the face of Nadalia. These are the final two women left in this Women's Championship number one contender Battle Royal. As now look at this. Kylie trying to eliminate Nadalia, trying to get any sort of momentum to shift Nadalia over the top rope, but there's a big elbow right to the nose of Kylie. Some shots by Nadalia here. Either one of these women are desperate to win this Women's Battle Royal because it means that they could go on to face Risa Master. And look at this, an elimination. No, no, no. And look at this. Oh, wait, wait, wait. Nadalia holds on. These women now trying to force each other over the top rope here. Could we be seeing an elimination by Nadalia? What is Risa Master doing? Oh, wait, wait, wait. What is Reese doing? Reese just cost Nadalia this Battle Royal. Oh, come on. That leaves Kylie to be the victor.
Here is your winner and the new number one contender for the Slamforce Women's Championship, Kylie.
And Kylie now is going on to be number one contender for the Slamforce Women's Championship. Congratulations to Kylie on the big win here tonight on Slamforce. And she made history in the first ever women's main event, first ever women's battle royal in Slamforce history. Kylie is the victor. Too bad for Nadalia after getting attacked and cost this battle royal. I thought it was going to be Nadalia to pick up the win in this battle royal, but it wasn't. Kylie's going on to, at some point in the future, challenge Risa Master for the Women's Championship. Guys, thank you for tuning in to Slamforce. What an amazing show it has been, and Kylie is walking away with a big victory. Don't forget to tune into our next episode as we head in to Slammania.